Hi, everyone. It's good to have you here with us. The Bible tells us that despite all things, we are overwhelmingly victorious through Christ Jesus because he loves us, and he loves us immensely. But we also recognize we do have moments as Christians where we are in the valley, but equally we have moments where we are on the mountaintop. And I think it's important for us to share not just the valley stories, but the mountaintop stories as well. And today it's fantastic to have Danie with us, and he's going to share with us what God's been doing and his mountaintop story. It's good to have you here with us, Danie.
Thanks, Dave. Thanks for having me. And it has been a good story. It's been an interesting story with COVID over the last 4 months, having to navigate this very interesting times that we find ourselves in. But I think what I want to share really starts a few months ago, where we had actually just gone into lockdown. And as a company, thankfully, we didn't really experience the negativity that a lot of other businesses had during that time. And it was a case of our clients have been and have done well during this time. And because of that, we're in the marketing consulting space. Because of that, we've managed to do well, and we've been employing and growing throughout lockdown. But as I was saying, initially, colleagues and people in the industry would ask, how's it going? How's business? And I would catch myself saying that, it's going well today. We've just got a new contract or a new client, but I don't actually know what tomorrow looks like, or I don't know what next year looks like. And that's really where the risk is, in the longer term growth and the sustainability of the clients and the contracts we have. And, God really convicted my heart, because the word tells us clearly that we shouldn't worry about tomorrow. Tomorrow will worry about itself. And I think something really shifted, in my heart, and we engaged with the team, and we said, guys, let's focus on today. Let's focus on gratitude and thankfulness. I think Alphonse alluded to that on Sunday, saying, look at our situation and just be thankful for what we have and what we've been given. We spoke about this, the parable in the Bible where we hear of the talents, where one guy gets given a talent and the others more, but the one with one talent decides to actually put it in the ground, probably out of fear of failure, and the master is not pleased with what he decides to do, where the other guys, they obviously step out and try to make what they've been given more. And I think we can be, we'll realize that if we're honest with ourselves, there's always someone with a worse situation than what we find ourselves in. And I suppose for me, an encouragement has really been to focus on what we've been given to steward, because that's what we'll answer to God for one day, and what we're responsible for, and to just do that with excellence. Something else that's really, really excited me and been a huge blessing for me during this time is just seeing how our team has come together during this time. Of the last 5 months, I think 3 or 4 of them have obviously been from a remote work scenario. And it's just been incredible to see how the team's unified during this time over the technology that's available, and really continue to deliver at the highest levels as we've been fortunate, to be very busy. And it's just been very humbling, to be part of a team that's done as well as what we've done. And I think for me, the takeout really has been to just be grateful, every day, to focus on what's in front of us, to serve with excellence, and to really just be thankful for what we have. It might not seem like a lot, but like I say, we all of us know that there's always someone with a lot less. Mm.
Thanks, Danie. And you said to me beforehand as well that all good things come from the Father. You recognize this business has been given to you by God, and I know in your heart you want to give him glory. Thanks for sharing the story. Really appreciate it.
Thanks, Dave. Thanks for having me.